Here we are, working through another question on the certified Q&A for the Google Cloud Platform Associate Cloud Engineer. It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this project scenario, you work in a small company where everyone should be able to view all resources of a specific project. You want to grant them access following Google's recommended practices. What should you do? The key parts of this question are that you want to give a view permission to everybody for a specific resource. You want to follow Google's recommended practice also. I'm just going to highlight this once that this specific project is for a small company. Sometimes the recommended practices for enterprises are different from what might be applicable for a small company or a test project. Given that, let's look at the options that we currently have. There seems to be a few groups of options. In this case, A and C suggest that we use the gCloud tool and apply a command called add IAM policy binding. Whereas B and D suggest that we use the gCloud command line tool to do IAM roles create. In another set of groups, we have A and B, which starts off suggesting that we create a script, whereas C and D suggest that we create a new Google crew. When you're confronted with these options in a real-world project, it is easy to eliminate certain options that are suggested to you or that people come to you with if you know that they don't work for some reason. Either they are technically infeasible or they are not a recommended practices or it is not suitable for the current requirement. So we are going to take the same approach and try and eliminate certain groups of options so that we are left with one of the better ones. Let's start with gCloud IAM roles create. Looking at the documentation for this, or just intuitively looking at how it is named, it seems that we are adding a new IAM role. We are creating a new role. So when do we want to create a new role? We want to create a new role when existing roles are not available. When there are no primitive or predefined roles that suit your business requirement, it is at that point that you say, okay, now let's go create a custom role. In this case, however, there are some roles, in this case, a primitive role that suits our requirement. The primitive roles themselves, the major ones are viewer, editor, and owner, and viewer gets viewer read access to resources. Our requirement is that everyone be able to view all resources of a specific project. Therefore, for us, an existing suitable primitive role is there. And there is no need for us to create a new role. With that understanding now, we can eliminate options B and D, which both suggest creating a new role, which is unnecessary for us. Now let's look at the common options in A and C, which is to add IAM policy binding. What is a policy? A policy connects a member or identity to a resource. So you're essentially granting permissions to a resource for certain members or users. Looking at the documentation, it says you're adding a policy binding for that project. In this case, that is what we want. We want to be able to add a view permission to a specific project. And this seems to be the right approach that we need to get this done. Therefore, options A and C have some part of it which is correct. Let us check the others now. How about the option of creating a script to either add IAM policy binding or to do a roles create, which we already eliminated? But what about the option of creating a script? Is that a suitable approach? The questions we should ask are, what happens if new employees join? Are we going to be running the script again? If you're going to run the script, is it going to apply to all the existing users once more? Or are we going to just create a list of the new people and then run the script on them? What happens when an employee leaves? Do we have yet another script that removes the permissions for that particular employee? And what happens if we want to audit who has what access? Is that yet another script? Overall, there seems to be just too much manual work with additional maintenance in taking this approach of creating scripts. It is also not user-friendly. There's a lot more work for the IT admin to run these scripts and maintain them. Overall, this option does not scale well, and therefore we can eliminate any option that has got create a script as a starting point. How about the suggestion that we create a new Google group? What is a Google group? In Google Cloud, there are 5 different identities of members. You can either have your own personal Gmail account, you can have an email account via Cloud Identity or G Suite that gives you a custom email ID at yourorganization.com or yourorganization.org, whatever the domain name is. When you want to have not users logged in and doing something, but when the actor is a VM or an application and you want them to talk to each other without human interaction, then you can use a service account. The fifth way of doing this is to create a group of these members. So it is possible to create a group that has a Gmail account, that has a Cloud Identity or G Suite account, that has a service account, or even nested groups within which you can have all of this in one place. To this group now, you can add members or you can remove members. Now, given that we know what a group is, let's find out what are the best practices for policy management, especially around groups. The first one suggests that we set organization level cloud IAM policies to grant access to all projects in your organization. So the recommendation here is that when you have an organization, it is better to have certain policies set at the organization level than have individual projects and project owners define what should be the policies. In which case you will get a very varied approach across all projects as opposed to a single approach, a unified approach for your entire organization. So ideally, when you have a new organization, set these policies in place and let everybody use the same thing. In this case, the requirement itself demands this. So this best practice is something we need to achieve as part of this question. The next one says, we grant roles to a Google group instead of individual users when possible. It is easier to add members and remove members from a Google group instead of updating a Cloud IAM policy to add or remove users. What does this mean? Let us assume we've got different members in your organization. A Gmail account, a Cloud Identity account, G Suite account, service account. Do you want to go and apply role 1, role 2 to the first Gmail account? Then again, role 1, role 2 to the second Gmail account? Role 1, role 2 to a service account? And then role 1, role 2 to yet another service account? And you keep on doing this for each person who's entering the organization, and you have to remove it for each person who's leaving the organization. This is just extremely cumbersome. So the alternative is that you create a Google group, add the members that you want into that Google group, and then assign the roles only to the Google group itself. Once the overall Google group has the required roles and permissions, they are automatically inherited by everybody inside that group. Which means that now when users or employees are added or they're removed, all they need is to be added to this group and they automatically get these permissions. So this is much more easier to work with. Given that, we can see that this would be one of the easiest approaches to manage this requirement where we should have everyone able to view all the resources of a specific project, whether that person is now or in the future, they can easily be added to the group, and if they need to leave, they can be removed from the group. So the option of creating a new Google group is a good suggestion. Now, combining the options that we found good and the ones that were not workable, we can see that creating a script, not a good idea. Adding IAM policy binding, that's the right approach that we want. Creating a new role, not a good approach. We already have a role that suits our requirement and we don't need to create a new one. Looking at all of them together, only option C has both options that are suitable for us, and therefore it is the right option for this answer. Sorry, is the right response for this question. What are the key learnings from this question? IAM is fundamental to all cloud services. You absolutely need to know this. Learn about members, roles, permissions, policies. Best practices for products and solutions are tested on the exam. For any product or solution, if there is a best practice list, please go through them. In this specific case, because we are working with Google Groups, you've learned the best practices for that also. Also know what are the different kinds of roles, primitive, predefined, and custom roles. When would you use what? And also the best practices, say, for example, in working with custom roles. I will leave you with a few references around groups, how you can add a group to another group, which is a nested group, and various ways in which you should do IAM securely and in recommended ways. If you thought that content was great, you absolutely must check out all our new upcoming content. So subscribe right away.